Millions of Americans rely on Medicare in their retirement.
Millions,
and millions more will do so in the future.
We need more.
They pay for this benefit during their working years. They earn it.
We need more corruption.
But with an aging population and rising health care costs,
we need more benefits.
Too fast to sustain the
program. More benefits for the medical grifters.
The system, while protecting current beneficiaries, it won't be there when future
All
retirees.
All right. Come on. I've heard this before.
We have to reform Medicare to strengthen it. I am also.
Right. So, how do you reform it already? What are you cutting? What are you cutting? Are you cutting one specialist a year or what? You're letting those who go from doctor to doctor for nothing pay a dime? They're nothing to do, the old people. They go from one doctor to the
also
other just to have attention paid to them.
Republicans who don't believe we should raise taxes on those who are most fortunate and can best afford it.
Who, like the ones who support you?
You
mean those at Martha's Vineyard? I'm tired of this crap!
Most people in this country struggle to make ends meet. A few of
not Michelle, though.
Citizens,
she spent $10 million of taxpayer money last year.
Tax breaks and loopholes that nobody else gets.
And what about the loophole of Air Force
right
One and Air Force Two that you two got all of a sudden your hands on? What a loophole that is.
He has asked us to fix.
I'm sorry. I can't
we
take much more of him.
Tax code where everyone gets a fair shake.
Start with General Electric paying $1 on their $5 billion in American income. Ask Jeff Immelt of GE how he gets away with paying nothing on $5 billion in General Electric income in the U.S. And then tell us about Warren Buffett, Mr. Shaky from Omaha, about the deal he got with Bank of America after meeting with you. It's better than the solar company, the deal he got.
I'll also offer ideas to reform a corporate tax code that stands as a monument to special interest influence in Washington.
Like GE.
By eliminating pages of loopholes and deductions, we can lower one of the highest corporate tax rates in the world.
How?
Our tax code should not give an advantage to companies that can afford the best connected lobbyists. It should give
you
an advantage
like General
to
Electric, Jeff Immelt sitting in a box right next to a Pinocchio Obama. I have never heard anything like this. Someone should scream out, "You lie." I'd like one person to scream out, "You are lying. Liar, tell us about GE." One person. Let one man scream out, liar, tell us about Jeff Immelt of General Electric,
so
who's clapping right now.
Pay down our debt and pay for this jobs plan in the process.
I can't take it. I'll tell you why. I'm embarrassed to be an American. A, because of the shyster in the White House, the imposter. B, because of the claps every 2 minutes till he finishes a statement. You know, when you even listen to a speech from Portugal, they let the man deliver an intellectually detailed concept before the morons jump up like trained seals every 2 seconds, whether it be R's or D's. I've never seen anything like it. A nation of dummies.
Should we keep tax breaks for millionaires and billionaires?
You mean like the people you just had dinner with on Martha's Vineyard?
Graduate ready for college and good jobs.
Good jobs, yeah. The dummies come out after partying and using drugs for 6 years, they're going to have a job vacant. They can't write their own name.
This isn't
went to college. The dummy went to college on a special grant. The dummy spent 6 years smoking dope, snorting cocaine, and getting sex every 2 minutes. And he comes out, he wants to be the CEO, and if he doesn't get it, he screams racism.
And I'm pretty sure I know what most Americans would choose. It's not even close. And it's time for us to do what's right for our future.
We will come back in a moment, and I'm not going to do much more of this. Pinocchio Obama, I cannot take any more of this. It's more largesse for the unions, period, end of story.